exit tunnel. We'll get you out as fast as possible.
Creek Tunnel was not cheap. It took a lot of money to build it, and it's something people literally will never see.
Design of the Maline Tunnel started in 2012. Actual construction started in 2016. So about 4 years for design, 4 years for construction.
This whole project was literally like building a ship in a bottle.
I believe that the residents probably don't really have a good grasp of what it takes and what happens behind the scenes. The engineering and the dollars that are spent to protect the environment and also their health and safety is pretty amazing.
This is our chance to show our customers what the money's going toward, and how it's going to improve water quality in the St. Louis region.
We get a chance to save our planet, so to speak. So that's what I'm most proud about.
On top of that, it's a 3/4 mile tunnel, 28 feet in diameter, nearly 200 feet underground in the bedrock. It's pretty cool.
We're scanning, doing a 3D model of the Maline Creek Tunnel.
We're taking four large construction lights on tripods with batteries. We have a tripod for the camera that has been fitted with a light pack around the camera package. I'm Kirk Schilling, and I am a partner and camera operator for Envelop, and going down in the hole.
The pump station crew had been here since 5 a.m. The rest of us, production-wise, got in at about 8, geared up. Did our safety briefing.
First thing we're going to do is we'll go over some roles and responsibilities.
Climb into the basket, head down.
We have to do comm checks every 5 minutes. We check atmosphere. We're working under a strict protocol of confined space entry. On your emergency escape breather.
I chose not to go down because I have an incredible fear of snakes and rats. I'm Nancy Pasternak. I'm the producer of this virtual tour. The pictures look great so far, and I'm excited to put it all together.
It's kind of exciting because you have to come down all the way on this cage. Once you get down there, it's completely pitch black, and it's a bit of a different environment, not something that anybody's used to.
And I am the relay signal person to the crane operator. They send batteries up for charging, or we're sending batteries charged back down to them. We'll lower things in a bucket or tools, whatever they need.
It's a chance to show people, let them explore it, experience it in a way that nobody except the guys who actually built it have been able to see it before.
It gave me a little bit of heartache because the tunnel is 200 feet in the ground. And when you're putting people down in that kind of an atmosphere, it does create a little anxiety to make sure that the air is safe.
Safety was our biggest thing. And the last 2 or 3 months, there have been a couple of guys working around the clock to figure out the safety end of things to make sure that we can do this with zero risk.
At the end of Riverview down here, we're using 2 15-horsepower fans to adequately give enough air exchanges in the tunnel to maintain a safe atmosphere.
Gas meter to check that. We've got the rebreather in case we have any kind of air issues. Fall harness, a lanyard, gloves, a hard hat, safety glasses.
And then, of course, the muck boots.
In order to keep an accurate location of the personnel inside the tunnel, we do a 5-minute radio comm check. So in an unlikely event an emergency would happen, we would be able to pinpoint within a 10-foot radius of where they are inside the pipe.
We can try to explain it, but it's hard to visualize and understand something this scale that you can't see, that works in a way that, maybe doesn't make sense. Hopefully, we'll be able to answer those questions with this.